sample set is set to 1 inch. So when it goes down, it'll go down 1 inch, but it'll be 7/8 inch boards. Should be live edge on both sides. Shouldn't take me to 12, so I shouldn't hit the dogs. We'll see. Yeah, 12 and a quarter. Shouldn't hit the dogs. Should be all right. So same thing, that's a pretty nice looking board. Well, that's what happens when you sharpen your blade about 9 times. I never felt it. I never felt it going. A lot of times you'll feel it skipping. A lot of times you'll feel it jumping and bouncing. And I did feel it jumping and bouncing about right here. But I never felt it before that cut, jumping and bouncing. So, just happens. It's just where we're at. Let's get that out of there. That'll be a fun chore. I'll probably just back this off, run it through there, and chop out the board. So let's see where we're at. It's kind of easy to release for some reason. I don't think this blade's supposed to be all down there, is it? So we gotta check the belts after every time you break a blade. But it looks like that belt's good. And it looks like that belt's good. I don't know. Could be a rip down there at the bottom. Just have to see. Blade's still sitting right there. See if we can get it out of there. This is definitely time for gloves. Should be able to back the head up out of there. Oh well, this blade's pretty tight right here. That blade is in there. Just got caught in the sawdust chute. I mean, it's not inside it, it's just wound up there. My diesel drip. Yep. Alright, so blade's in there pretty good. Oh, there she is. Alright, let's see if we can back it up. And now we're free. Oh, I always think I'm blade breaking is my fault. You know, maybe there's too much sap buildup on there. I am getting a lot of sap off these. But I don't think that was my fault.
And that belt went.
Oh, because this isn't released yet. So, I don't think it tore it up. You know, you can see where the blade gouged into it. A couple places. See, the teeth marks just took off a little bit right there and there. But it's still definitely, and right there it got it. But there's no cracks or tears. No big damage to the belt. I think we're good. At least on this one. Time to switch sides of the belt. Every blade, switch sides. Take a look at this one real quick. This is a dry belt. And she looks good. I don't know. Who knows what the camera's seeing. But I don't see. There's one little blade mark there. There's a little scratch there. Not bad. Switch belts, put the blade on, and try it again.
All right, new blade. Let's see how it rides.
Riding right where it's supposed to be.
Maybe a little bit more of a drip.
Okay, let's go get rid of those slabs, get rid of some of these, stack them up. We'll be ready to cut some jack pine. Look at these dark nuts here, pretty cool how dark they are down here at the base. Some of them up here aren't dark yet, but I think during in the middle they'll get darker, I hope. So take the top off this one, just to take out in case there was a wave in there. I'm sure it was waving if it was about to break. And then I'll get back down to going in 1 inch. He's almost got good sides on both. Should be good to go.